Why doesn't blocking email senders work? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Let's get right to the question. How can I block addresses that come repeatedly in my junk email box? It says I'm blocking email, but it doesn't work. Blocking using the from address is pointless. I'll just be as blunt as I possibly can. It is completely pointless. You're wasting your time. It promises to block email from that specific sender, and it might, but spammers know this and they use other techniques, many other techniques, to completely render that ineffective. I'll explain why it's pointless and what to do instead. First, I didn't want to address this comment that they're going into your spam folder. Honestly, that's the system working as it's supposed to. If your spam is automatically landing in your spam folder, you're done. There's really nothing more to do. That's how spam is dealt with. Now, if it's showing up in your inbox, that's different. And that's when you do things like mark it as spam. But if it shows up in your spam folder, there's really nothing more you can do. And I want to be clear, on those systems where you can block a sender, for many of them, all that really means is the mail goes to the spam folder. They're not really rejecting the email. They're not really preventing it from being sent to you. They're just automatically moving it to the spam folder because you've quote unquote blocked them. So not only is the system working properly, blocking something that's already going to the spam folder is really just telling it to, keep sending it to the spam folder and nothing else. I want to point out that the reason blocking senders doesn't work is because senders can be faked. Let's have a quick look at a couple of examples. Here's an email address from me, Leo A. Notenboom, leo@somerandomservice.com. Now, there are two pieces to what you'll find in your from line. One is what we call the display name. It's the human readable name of your contact. In this case, Leo A. Notenboom. That's followed by the actual email address in angle brackets, leo@somerandomservice.com. Now, some email programs don't show you both parts. Instead, what they do is they just show you the human readable part and then hide the actual email address. So what that means is instead of seeing the full thing, what you might see instead is from Leo A. Notenboom, possibly underlined, indicating that there's more information, the email address behind that name. But all they're going to show you is the name. Okay, here's where spammers and others get tricky. Have a look at this one. From nancy@reallybigbookstore.com, angle brackets, leo@somerandomservice.com. Now, that first part, nancy@reallybigbookstore.com, it looks like an email address. It's formatted like an email address, except it's not an email address. What they've done is they've taken the display name, the human readable name, and replaced it with an email address. Even though it looks like an email address, it actually is not used as an email address. It's simply something that is displayed. The real email address for this from line is leo@somerandomservice.com. Now, it gets weird when you're in those email programs that only show you the display name. Then you will see from nancy@reallybigbookstore, except that's not the email address. If you then look at what the email address is behind that display name, you'll see that it's really leo@somerandomservice.com. That's one way spammers fool you. That's one way they try and fake you into misunderstanding where email comes from. But it's not the worst scenario. The real reason, the biggest reason that blocking senders fails is because spammers never send from the same email address twice. In other words, they'll send it from leo@somerandomservice.com and you'll block leo@somerandomservice.com. And you're right, you may never be able to get another email from leo@somerandomservice.com. Except the spammers aren't going to be sending from that anymore. They're using all the other email addresses that they can find and faking the from line. It's called from spoofing. It's very easy to do, and what it does is it means that the from line in an email, especially in spam, is completely irrelevant. It has nothing to do with where the spam actually came from. What that means is that blocking this irrelevant email address is pointless, because the spammers are going to keep sending you email from different email addresses. So, what do you do? Well, as I alluded to earlier, if spam is showing up in your spam folder, there's nothing more you need to do, nothing more you really can do. If, however, the spam is showing up in your inbox, then mark it as spam. The idea is that this will then train the email program's spam filter to say, yeah, this email, this is what spam looks like, so that more and more, it'll hopefully do a better job of identifying spam based on what you've told it spam looks like. So if blocking doesn't work for spam, is it good for anything? Well, yeah, actually, it's good for anyone that is sending from a consistent email address that you don't want to hear from. Maybe you've created an enemy on the internet. None of us have ever done that, I'm sure. But if there's somebody, some specific person that continues to send you email from a consistent email address that you don't want to see, sure, block that. That may prevent it from showing up at all. It may just move it to your spam folder, but the bottom line is it won't show up in your inbox. Now, they can, if they are motivated enough, bypass that just like the spammers do by sending from a different email address. But in the case of one-to-one, or especially in the case of companies that aren't really paying attention, they're just sending you stuff from their specific email address, yeah, blocking can work. But it's only when they're sending from a consistent address in the from line that's accurate, that doesn't change, where blocking will work. When it comes to spam, blocking remains totally ineffective. I hope that helps you understand exactly why that's the case. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/4731. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.